And even if I couldn't do any of the field detective work, I think there's a lot of things I could do in organization or
because you can't, you're not licensed for firearms, right?
Not licensed for firearms.
We'll be right back with more of Mark Furman. Don't go away.
In the league, these legs have more miles on them than most mini fans. That's why I never play a game without my Ginsana. Ginsana's got G115 ginseng, the real stuff.
The lasting energy of G115 is real. It's what makes Ginsana different from everything else on the shelf.
You can feel your age, or you can feel your Ginsana.
Feel your Ginsana.
Someday there will be no subways or corporate ladders to climb. If retirement is a bridge to be crossed when we get there, then we must accept whatever lies ahead of us. If it is one we must build, then let us begin.
Is that your Mercedes-Benz?
Yeah, it is.
Nice tie. Would you step away from the car, please? I was behind you back there, and you were going really slow.
Slow?
Look, I'm going to have to write you up, driving a luxury car without enough horsepower.
Seville STS with a 300-horsepower Northstar system. More horsepower than any car in its class.
Oh, you some kind of cop?
Something like that.
Tuesday on CNN's Larry King Live. Former L.A. detectives Philip Van Atter and Tom Lang on why they think Mark Furman lies in his book. Plus Simpson defense attorney F. Lee Bailey. Tuesday, 9 Eastern on CNN.
In our remaining moments with Mark Furman, we'll have some closing words at the end solo here. We were talking about the Ramsey matter in Colorado and whether as a detective that's the kind of thing you'd like to be on.
Oh yeah, it looks like it's a great whodunit from what I know. And
classic.
It's a classic, you know, and the tragedy is there's a dead girl. So
now, can you imagine, I guess for a police officer, you have children, the killing of a child?
No, I never got used to that. Never did.
You could, an infant or a five-year-old, six-year-old?
No, early in my career, I had an opportunity to go to child abuse. They actually asked me to come there because of a report and an investigation I did on a child abuse, and they actually asked if I wanted to come to the unit. And they investigated child abuse homicides, and I said, I just can't do that.
You're telling me your son nearly drowned, right? You saved him?
Last year. Got there.
What happened?
We were skiing, and we pulled in, and all the kids were playing a little sandy beach area, and you know, it's like one of those things, boy, you just look to your right and all of a sudden, where's my boy? And I just started yelling, where is he? And just instinct, I heard a splash at the end of the dock, and he had tried to get into the ski boat and fell between the dock and the boat, and just as I got there, he was about 2 feet under and just going, and I just reached down and grabbed him.
Tough. Second, look the wrong way.
Oh, jeez.
Nothing worse than life. How old is he?
He was three then.
We asked you last time, what are you going to do with the rest of your life? And you talked, you didn't really know.
No, I mean...
Given it some more thought, now that I've told...
I'd like to work on abductions and maybe the paranormal. We could open up the X-Files again. Mulder and I would go out there and find some aliens.
Thanks. You and Whitley Strieber go take a ship and go up and...
Yeah. Well, you know, I joke around about that, but I'm a big fan of the X-Files, and I love the way Mulder is absolutely passionately obsessed with his investigations, to the point where he turns everybody else off and they give him a room in the basement, and he gets exactly what he wants. He gets a room to himself, and he can actually investigate this stuff.
Do you ever get obsessed with the case?
I think obsessed with the point where I can't stop thinking about it. The wheels are always turning, and I'm making phone. My wife, you know, she used to get so upset. I'd be making phone calls across the country.
That's a curse, isn't it?
It probably is. You never really let go of anything. And
the good detective, while he may not be overly emotionally involved, does take the case home.
I used to take my cases home. I'd let my wife look at the cases. I'd make phone calls on my own phone across the country on the weekends. And I drove her crazy a little bit sometimes, but sometimes you just can't do everything in that daytime during the week, so take it home.
Are you a fan of Columbo?
Yeah, my wife is especially. She loves that show.
Do you like NYPD Blue?
Great show. Great show.
Is that as close to realism as it gets?
It's pretty good. And it's a pretty it's pretty raw for TV sometimes, and it actually borderlines the point where we'd almost call it misconduct at sometimes, but it's very entertaining.
30 seconds left. Do you think this is ever going to go away?
I hope the whole case goes away someday. I hope this doesn't take on the quality of the JFK assassination. This is not anywhere close. This is an easy case to solve. Simpson did it.
Never a doubt in your mind.
Never a doubt in my mind.
Thanks, Mark.
Thanks, Larry.
Mark Fremen will have him back with UFOs in a couple months. The book is Murder in Brentwood. The foreword is by Vincent Bugliosi, and the publisher is Regnery. This is Larry King Live. Some special words about a great lady who passed away today, right after this.
You know, AT&T is making long-distance calls from home simple. And now, a guarantee.
Guarantee?
Yeah, okay. If you're not satisfied that their prices are competitive, you get a month of long-distance free.
Up to $100 worth.
Right. I have AT&T. Yeah. It's the best value.
They got the most powerful network.
Yeah. What if I call?
You know, if you have any questions, just call it.
1-800-COMPARE.
I have a sister.
This is not the time.
AT&T quality, service, and guaranteed competitive prices. So you never have to worry about long-distance prices again.
What kind of pen do you have in your pocket? If you're like this guy, it's a Pilot pen. He likes the way it writes. And if it's our Dr. Grip, it actually makes writing easier. The secret is in the grip. It's designed by a doctor to cut writer's cramp by 40%. So you'll see how well it writes and feel how comfortable it is. No wonder so many pockets carry a Dr. Grip pen. The Pilot Dr. Grip. It's available in a mechanical pencil, too.
From the moment you hit the street, you're on the run. Watch your back. This may be your only chance to get away. Grab it. Catch the partner. John Grisham's new novel of legal suspense. Reserve your copy now.
Introducing a new kind of fixident. A fixident with no artificial flavors or colors. Introducing new Fixident Free. It's got the strongest, longest hold of any free adhesive with no artificial flavors or colors. Fixident and forget it with new Fixident Free.
Tuesday night, NBA on TNT. See three All-Stars, two all-time greats, and one slam dunk champion. Watch the Lakers face the Rockets. Lakers, Rockets. Tuesday night at 8, the NBA's on TNT. Don't miss a game.
We end on a sad note tonight. Excuse me. One of Ted Turner's closest advisors and friends, Dolores Woods, D. Woods, died this weekend of cancer. She was only 60 years old. D. played a key role during the years that Turner Broadcasting grew from a single television station to a global powerhouse, rising from secretary to vice president. In Ted Turner's own words, quote, she is irreplaceable, and her death is a terrible loss to her family and my family. She was one of the last great Southern ladies with style and grace and charm. We will all miss her. Our thoughts are with her husband, Larry, and her children tonight. Bye, Dee.